the gospel reflection of the day from the Congregation of the Daughters of St. Paul. As the day begins, listen, reflect, and live the Word of God, the best food ever for the soul.
It is Wednesday, 17th January 2024, the second week in Ordinary Time. The theme of our reflection today is to save or to kill. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark, chapter 3, verses 1 to 6. Again Jesus entered the synagogue, and a man was there who had a withered hand. And they watched him to see whether he would heal him on the Sabbath, so that they might accuse him. And he said to the man who had the withered hand, "Come here." And he said to them, "Is it lawful on the Sabbath to do good or to do harm, to save life or to kill?" But they were silent. And he looked around at them with anger, grieved at their hardness of heart, and said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He stretched it out, and his hand was restored. The Pharisees went out and immediately held counsel with the Herodians against him, how to destroy him. The Gospel of the Lord. From the Gospel of John, chapter 10, verses 10, we read, "I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly." Jesus Christ lives this very teaching in the Gospel of today. He gives life, not death. He saves. He does not kill. Jesus Christ is the God of life. Our present culture is fostering the culture of death, whereas Jesus fosters life. He wishes life for all of us. When other people are fostering death through abortion, through euthanasia, Jesus Christ today asks us, "Is it against the law?" Jesus Christ, who is the Word of God, heals the sick man by his word. He tells him, "Stretch out your hand." He comes to save, not to kill. His word brings healing and life. In the Gospel today, Jesus Christ is aware of the importance of the Sabbath. He himself is a pious Jew who goes to the temple often, and he reads in the synagogue on the Sabbath. Jesus' awareness of the importance of the Sabbath does not prevent him from restoring life and wholeness to someone in need. As Christians, we observe Sundays and other holy days. In observing these days, let us strive for goodness towards others. An act of kindness to someone else should not be postponed to a Monday when we can do it on a Sunday. Jesus Christ says to each and every one of us, "I ask you, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save a life rather than destroy it?" This is our time to follow the example of Jesus. We can do this by fostering the values that promote life, that better our lives. Some of these values are compassion, humility, and kindness. And so let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you came to seek and to save that which was lost. In this, you served and offered your life for us all. We humbly pray that we in our lives may have the grace to protect this earthly life as we journey to the everlasting life, for you are Lord forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise be Jesus Christ.
The Gospel Reflection of the Day from the Congregation of the Daughters of St. Paul. As the day begins, listen, reflect, and live the Word of God, the best food ever for the soul.